Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. I am Dr. Mangesh Doshi. In continuation with the last video, that is organic qualitative analysis, this is the second video, that is qualitative analysis of organic compounds. This video will contain type determination for the individual compound, preliminary test, determination of saturation or unsaturation, and determination of aromaticity. Friends, in last video we have seen a separation of solid solid, solid liquid and liquid liquid binary mixture, and we have seen the type determination for solid solid binary mixture. Now in this case we will see the type determination for the single component which is isolated from or separated from solid liquid and or liquid liquid binary mixture. As we know that the organic substances are of four types depending upon their functional group. Those types are acids, phenols, bases and neutrals. For determination of a type of single compound, adopt the following procedure. Before going to the test for the type determination, we have to do the solubility test. Either that substance or solid or liquid is soluble in water or not. For that purpose, take a approximate 5 mg substance in a test tube and add 1 ml cold water. Then the substance and shake with. Then substance should be either water soluble or miscible. Soluble, this term is used for the solid, while miscible is term used for the liquids. If water soluble, water miscible, homogeneous transparent liquid is obtained, then water soluble or miscible substance is present. But if turbid solution is obtained, then water insoluble or immiscible. This is the observation. Then water insoluble or immiscible substance is present. Now for the type determination, there are two types of tables. One table is for water soluble, water miscible substances, and second table for the water insoluble, immiscible substance present. So first we will start with the type determination for water miscible, water soluble compounds. Miscible, this term is used for the liquid, and soluble, this term is used for the solid. We have to follow this test. As we know that our substance either liquid or soluble in water, so type determination for water soluble or water miscible substances, that is very easy. So in that solution, whatever the water solution of the compound, we have to take the litmus test. So there are two types of litmus, blue and red. Suppose blue litmus turns red, then organic compound contains acid or phenol. So that is acid or phenol may be present, that is the inference. If red litmus turns blue, then base may be present. If there is no change in either litmus paper, then neutral substance is present. So in this way, by using a litmus paper, you can say the type of the organic substance, acid or phenol. If blue litmus turns red, red litmus turns blue, then base is present. If there is no change in either litmus paper, color of either litmus paper, then neutral substance is present. Now, if first test is observed, acid or phenol, then we have to distinguish either acid is there or phenol is there. That's why we have to take the next test. Take a 10 mg of the substance and add 4-5 drops of 10% sodium bicarbonate, that is NHCO3. If we are observing the effervescence of CO2, then acid is present and confirmed. If there is no effervescence of CO2, then phenol may be present. If effervescence of CO2 is there, acid present and confirmed. But if there is no effervescence of CO2, phenol may be present. How to confirm the phenol? Then take the substance and add 4 drops of FeCl3, ferric chloride. If blue coloration is obtained, then you can say that phenol is present and confirmed. So in this way, by using a simple litmus paper, litmus test, and separation of acid and phenol, we can find out the given organic compound has which type: acid, phenol, बेस और न्यूट्रल। सेकेंड टेबल इज फॉर द टाइप डिटर्मिनेशन फॉर वाटर इमिसिबल इनसॉल्युबल कंपाउंड्स। फॉर टाइप डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ वाटर इमिसिबल और इनसॉल्युबल कंपाउंड्स वी हैव टू फॉलो दिस टेबल। देर आर थ्री टेस्ट, टेस्ट फॉर एसिड, टेस्ट फॉर फिनॉल, टेस्ट फॉर बेस। सो दिस टेस्ट यू हैव टू डू द सिक्वेंशियल मैनर। फर्स्ट इज टेस्ट फॉर एसिड, टेस्ट फॉर फिनॉल एंड टेस्ट फॉर बेस। दिस इज द टेस्ट, वी हैव टू स्टार्ट। टेक अ 10 mg ऑफ सब्सटेंस प्लस 10 drops ऑफ 10% NaHCO3। दिस इज द रिएजेंट फॉर द एसिड टेस्ट, वी शुड रिमेंबर। देन द ऑब्जर्वेशन शुड बी सोल्यूबल विथ इफरवेसेंस ऑफ CO2। वी कैन सी बबल्स ऑफ CO2 गैस एंड आवर सब्सटेंस क्वांटिटी बिकम्स लेस एंड लेस, सो सोल्यूबल विथ इफरवेसेंस ऑफ CO2, देन एसिड मे बी प्रेजेंट। आफ्टर दिस टेस्ट वी हैव टू कूल दिस सोल्यूशन एंड देन एड फ्यू ड्रॉप्स ऑफ कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड HCl टिल एसिडिक। इफ दैट सब्सटेंस इज गेटिंग रीप्रेसिपिटेटेड, मीन्स सोल्यूबल सब्सटेंस रीअपियर्स, देन एसिड प्रेजेंट एंड कन्फर्म। सो दिस इज द टेस्ट फॉर एसिड। सो इफ दैट सब्सटेंस इज सोल्यूबल इन सोडियम बाइकार्बोनेट एंड रीअपियर्स रीप्रेसिपिटेटेड इन कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड HCl सोल्यूशन, देन एसिड इज प्रेजेंट एंड कन्फर्म। इफ देर इज नो रिप्रेसिपिटेशन एंड नो इफरवेसेंस ऑफ CO2, देन वी हैव टू टेक द टेस्ट फॉर फिनॉल। इफ यू आर गेटिंग दिस टाइप, देन यू नो दिस इज द सिंगल कंपाउंड, यू आर गेटिंग अ टाइप एसिडिक, देन फर्दर टेस्ट शुड नॉट, यू शुड नॉट टेक द फर्दर टेस्ट because you are getting the type. But if acid is absent, then only you have to take the test for phenol. This is to be remembered. Now the test for phenol, take 10 mg of the substance and add 10 drops of 2 normal NaOH, shake well. If the compound completely soluble, then phenol may be present, and if that soluble reprecipitated by the concentrated HCl, then phenol is present and confirmed. समजा तो सब्सटन्स NaOH-मध्ये डिझॉल्व झाला, हा NaOH रिएजंट फॉर द फिनॉल। समजा तो जर फिनॉल डिझॉल्व झाला कशामध्ये, आपल्या NaOH-मध्ये, देन फिनॉल इज प्रेझेंट। आणि तो जर रिप्रेसिपिटेट झाला तर फिनॉल इज प्रेझेंट अँड कन्फर्म। फिनॉल जर आला तुमचा तर पुढची टेस्ट घेण्याची गरज नाही। फिनॉल जर ॲबसेंट आला, देर इज नो प्रेसिपिटेशन, देन ओनली टेक द टेस्ट फॉर बेस। So for the test of base, we have to take the 10 mg of substance plus add 10 drops of 1:1 HCl, 50% HCl, shake well, then completely soluble. If the completely soluble and reprecipitated by the 2 normal NaOH, if you are using excess, then base is present and confirmed. म्हणजे बघा, NaOCO3 मध्ये डिझॉल्व आणि रिप्रेसिपिटेटेड बाय द HCl झालं असेल तर ऍसिड इज प्रेझेंट अँड कन्फर्म। ॲसिड ॲबसेंट असेल तरच फिनॉलची टेस्ट घ्या। फिनॉलच्या टेस्टसाठी 2 नॉर्मल NaOH इज द रिएजंट। फिनॉल कम्प्लिटली रिप्रेसिपिटेटेड, कम्प्लिटली सोल्युबल इन NaOH अँड रिप्रेसिपिटेटेड बाय HCl, देन फिनॉल इज प्रेझेंट अँड कन्फर्म। फिनॉल आला तर पुढची टेस्ट घ्यायची गरज नाही, फिनॉल नाही आलं तरच पुढची टेस्ट घ्या या प्रकारे। समजा तीनही ॲबसेंट आले, इफ ऑल द टेस्ट 1, 2, and 3 आर निगेटिव, देन आवर कंपाउंड इज अ न्यूट्रल, देन यू हॅव टू कंक्लूड दॅट न्यूट्रल कंपाउंड इज प्रेझेंट। सो इन दिस वे वी हॅव टू डू द टाईप डिटर्मिनेशन टेस्ट फॉर वॉटर इनसोल्युबल, वॉटर इमिसिबल कंपाउंड्स। दीज आर द रिजन्स यू शूड रिमेंबर। टेस्ट फॉर ॲसिड 10% NaOCO3, टेस्ट फॉर phenol to normal NaOH, and test for base, that is 1:1 HCl. Then at the end you have to write the conclusion. Type of the given solid or liquid is, for example, acidic, phenol asel tar phenolic, base asel tar basic, and neutral asel tar neutral. So in this way you have to write the conclusion in one sentence and make a bracket for that one, for looking good and understanding purpose. Conclusion: type of the given solid or liquid is acidic. This is the example. Now go for the individual analysis of organic compound. After type determination, we have to do the individual analysis of each compound. That is the step 3. So that is preliminary test. So preliminary test are the primary test. This you have to carry out in within a few minutes. So these are giving the broad idea. What is there into the organic compound? What is the composition of organic compounds? But this is not sure. This is not confirmed. These are just a preliminary idea. This is giving the preliminary idea. So from that you can get the idea of what will be present into the organic compounds. This test you should carry out within the 5 or 10 minutes only into the laboratory. So first is a color. By looking at, you can write down the color. So either that is color or colorless or white solid. But then that compound may be benzoic acid, cinnamic acid, salicylic acid, oxalic acid, thalic acid, naphthalene, urea, thiourea, like this. If yellow solid is there, that may be nitroamines, nitrophenols, nitrobenzene. If orange solid is there, orthonitroaniline. If brown solid is there, maybe beta-naphthol. Pinkish, maybe resorcinol or paratolidine. Colorless liquid. If liquid is colorless, then acetone, chloroform, carbon tetrachloride, or esters like acetophenone, ketones. If yellow liquids, that may be aniline, nitrobenzene, dimethyl aniline. So by looking at the substance, either that is colored solid or colored liquid, you can get the idea of what may be the present into the organic compound. So this is giving you a broad idea. So within seconds, you can write the color of that compound and write the inference. Second preliminary test is the odor. Odor, smell. So for taking this test, do not touch the nose to the test tube. Just 5 to 10 centimeter away from the test tube, just take the odor. If that is pleasant odor, it may contain ketone, alcohol or chloroform. If phenolic odor, it may contain alpha phenol, alpha naphthol or beta naphthol or nitrophenol. If fishy smell, that is a characteristic smell for the amines. So our organic compounds may contain aniline, dimethyl aniline, paratolidine, likewise. Then action of sodium carbonate. So if CO2 effervescence is there, acid may be present or acid may be. If CO2 absent, then acid may be absent. Friends, in type determination, we are using this NaHCO3. So in that case also, we are getting that test for acid. So if acid is there, this test 100% will be positive. If acid is not there, this test will be 100% negative. So by using previous knowledge, previous test, you can write down this one also, or you can understand this reaction also. Then action of 10% NaOH. And this is the reagent for phenol. So if yellow color changes to orange color, nitrophenol is present. If no orange red color, nitrophenol may be absent. If completely soluble, then it may contain a phenol. So this is the action of NaOH test. So these are the four tests. Fifth test is a determination of saturation, unsaturation. So our compound contains saturation or unsaturation. Saturation means it is aliphatic compounds. It contains only carbon-carbon single bond. Unsaturated compounds means aliphatic compounds, but it may contain carbon-carbon double bond or carbon-carbon triple bond. So saturation means all single bonds, while unsaturation means compound may contain double or triple bonds. So for that purpose, we have to carry out two tests. First is action of Br2 in CCl4. Action of Br2 in CCl4. Take an organic substance, add some amount of CCl4 and then add some amount of Br2 in CCl4. Very small quantity, we have to add this one. So Br2 has a brown color. If a decoloration of that brown color of the Br2 then unsaturated substance is present. But if there is no decoloration, color of the Br2, that is brown color of Br2, remains as it is, then that is called as saturated substance is present. Now you should know the reactions of this one, why this color is decoloration happens or why decoloration is not happens. Suppose the organic compounds contain double or triple bond, Br2 gas, here CCl4 is acts as a solvent for the Br2 gas. So Br2 has a brown color, molecular Br2 has a brown color, but in case of CCl4 it shows an addition reaction. So this Br2 molecule will break and each Br will add it to the each double bonded carbon. Now this is the colorless derivative and there is no molecular Br2, so there is no brown color. So decoloration of brown color is only possible if the compound contains double or triple bond. So that is called as unsaturated substance. If the compound contains only single bonds, then this addition reaction is not possible. Then your product, in product, Br2 gas remains as it is. So brown color remains as it is. That is called as no decoloration. Then we can say that unsaturated substance is present. While doing these reactions, you should remember that you have to use Br2 in very small quantity. If we are using a Br2 in excess or some more amount, then what will happen? Whatever the compound is there, that will react with the Br2. But whatever the excess Br2, that shows a brown color. That shows a brown color. And what we can say then? No decoloration. So this is the wrong observation. For that purpose, we have to use a small quantity of Br2 in CCl4 as compared to our substance. Next test is for saturation unsaturation, is a Baer test. Baer test, in this case we have to use a dilute potassium permanganate solution. So how to carry out this test? Take a substance, then add sodium carbonate solution, alkaline it, then add a very dilute KMnO4 solution, very dilute. It should be a dilute, that it should be a pink looking, a pink color, a dilute pink color. Then if pink color of the KMnO4 disappears, then unsaturated substance is present. If there is no decolorization, then saturated substance is present. Why decoloration is there? It also shows an addition reaction. It also shows an addition reaction. Suppose organic compound contains double or triple bond. If you are using a KMnO4, it shows addition reactions. Alkene is converted to the diol, a diol form. So there is no molecular KMnO4 over here. So pink color of the KMnO4 will be disappear because KMnO4 is not there into the product. But if you are using KMnO4 in excess quantity, so after reaction also some amount of KMnO4 will remains in a solution and pink colors we can see that one. So in that case your observation will be no decoloration, but actual observation is what? KMnO4 was in excess. That's why while doing this test you should remember that KMnO4 must be very dilute and very small quantity. Then we can do the test for determination of aliphatic aromatic compounds. For organic quality analysis, it's very simple differentiation. Aliphatic means the compounds which doesn't contain aromatic rings, means benzene rings or benzene like rings. If the organic compounds contains benzene ring, then that is called as aromatic compounds. So for that purpose, a simple test you have should carry out. Take a 10 mg of substance on copper wire, copper gauge, and heat on the blue flame of the Bunsen burner. Flame should be blue. So take a 10 mg of substance and heat on the blue flame of the burner. This is not just heating, its burning of that substance. If while burning of that substance we are getting a sooty flame, sooty flame म्हणजे काळा धूर. ओके, सूट जसं टायर जाळल्यानंतर काळा धूर दिसतं बघा, त्याला म्हणतात सूटी फ्लेम. आणि त्याचा कलर पण येल्लो असतो. ब्ल्यू फ्लेम कशी होते? येल्लो. देन ॲरोमॅटिक सबस्टन्स इज प्रेझेंट. इफ देर इज नो सूटी फ्लेम, येलो फ्लेम नसेल, काळा धूर नसेल, देन दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज नो सूटी फ्लेम. देन आवर ऑर्गेनिक कंपाऊंड इज ॲलिफॅटिक. देन यू कॅन राईट ॲलिफॅटिक सबस्टन्स इज प्रेझेंट. If you see the green flame, then halogen is may be present. But if sooty flame, aromatic. If non-sooty flame, aliphatic substance is there. After doing this preliminary test, we had to write the conclusion in this manner. Conclusion: the given solid or liquid is acidic. So whatever the type is there, acid. If acid is there, you should write acidic. A should be capital. If phenol is there, phenolic. If base is there, basic. If neutral is there, neutral. Then unsaturated or saturated, you should write like this. Then aliphatic or aromatic. So in this way, there should be the three observation at the end of all preliminary test. And you should write in this manner conclusion. The given organic solid or liquid is acidic, saturated, unsaturated, or aliphatic, aromatic. Thank you, friends. In next video, we will see element detection of the organic compound. Thank you once again.